Hello, everyone, and welcome to another Fast Eating Golden Debate Show, EarlyMorningRock.com. If your own eyes didn't see it or your own ears didn't hear it, don't make your small mind fester, share it. Time's money and open minds on empty ones is the only way to achieve golden goals. Golden Show, Golden Debate Show, EarlyMorningRock.com, and your career.
Is everyone alright?
Golden Debate Show, Golden Show, EarlyMorningRock.com. Like, comment, share, and download as much as you possibly can and get the word of the show out. Open minds on empty ones. And let's stay golden and remember the golden rule, everybody.
Don't look over here.
Nothing to see.
Everybody
do.
Look at that.
Yeah!
I'm all in, those warp elements mixed in the lab, combined powerfully.
Wow.
So let's kick it off with a Joe Rogan Experience clip.
He'd say Richard Gere thought gerbil up the ass.
Right?
That's all anybody thought.
Yeah.
Well, when you talk about Al Gore now, especially around certain circles, he's a joke when it comes to the climate. Was there anything that he said that was debunked, or is it all bullshit?
No, they just kept attacking him.
That's fascinating.
And by the way, it's fascinating because what there is anyone says anything we don't like, we attack their character.
Mm-hmm.
And once we attack their character and they're on the defensive, then we fucking won.
Yeah.
Because then it's not about what they said.
Right.
It's about, well, fucking this person, we can't trust what he said because he'd like to finger up his ass on us. You know?
Yeah, absolutely. And that is a fascinating thing they do with comments on videos, like especially your kind of documentaries that expose things.
Yeah, we get it.
And they attack. And it's been proven now. I mean, that was part of the Snowden deal. We actually got to see fact that they spend money on propaganda, trying to influence. They go to websites, message 100%. Boards. They go to social chat. They go on 100%. Twitter. There's a lot of people that
I've got another question for you.
Okay.
Why isn't there more fucking outrage about the NSA listening to every fucking phone call, every tweet, every fucking email, every everything, and saying, we live in a goddamn police state. We signed away. Well, we never even signed it away, but our rights and freedoms. And I came to this country because it's land of the free, home of the brave, fucking beautiful country. I love it here. Gorgeous place.
Don't
Why
look over
is
here.
There more
Nothing
outrage with the NSA
here. Ooh, look at that.
Watching everything we do and doing it illegally?
I think there is outrage, but I think people feel like they are waiting for something to happen, and they don't know what they can do about it. They don't feel like they have any real legitimate power. They can express their outrage. They wait for the politicians to make some announcements. And
Fact!
I mean, what is the only thing that Obama said that they're going to try to slow it down somewhat or do something differently in some way? What are you doing?
I was just unblocking his face. A lot of people were saying they
want to
see
him.
Oh, fuck all those people.
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab, combined powerfully.
Cameras on the city block.
And finally,
triangly.
The bracketologist in chief
gunshot
is at it again. President Obama.
Hello, everybody. Mr.
As he
Obama
does
got
every
time for
March,
the
making his
for the way that the
predictions
economy
as to the madness with ESPN's and Katz. As the president was making his picks for the men's tournament, they had some fun with the possibility of perhaps the president winning Warren Buffett's $1 billion perfect bracket challenge.
Oh.
If you were to win that, what would you do with $1 billion? I'm sure somebody would ask me to pay down more of the federal debt.
Okay.
Michelle might want a few shoes.
Okay.
Smart man.
Yeah.
Constituents and wife. Keep them all happy. Yeah. And finally, the bracketologist in chief is at it again. President Obama, as he does every March, making his predictions.
I can't believe we made it. According to today's regulators and bureaucrats, those of us who were kids in the 50s, 60s, 70s, or even early 80s probably should not have survived.
Stay golden.
Our baby cribs were covered with bright-colored lead-based paint. We had no childproof lids or locks on medicine bottles, doors, or cabinets. And when we rode our bikes, we had no helmets. We drank water from the garden hose and not from a bottle. We ate cupcakes, bread, and butter, and drank soda with lots of sugar in it. But we were rarely overweight because we were always outside playing. We would leave home in the morning and play all day, as long as we were back when the streetlights came on. No one was able to reach us all day. Smartphones? We didn't have cell phones at all. No PlayStations, Xboxes, limitless channels on cable, laptops or tablets. Facebook was an actual face and an actual book. We had friends. We went outside and found them. We played dodgeball, and sometimes the ball would hurt. We fell out of trees, got cut, and broke bones and teeth. And there were no lawsuits from these accidents. No one was to blame but us. Remember accidents? We had fights and punched each other and got black and blue and learned to get over it.
Facts.
We made up games with sticks and tennis balls. And although we were told it would happen, we didn't put out any eyes. We rode bikes or walked to a friend's home, knocked on the door, rang the bell, or just walked right in and talked to him. Little League had tryouts.
I'm all in. Those whoop elements mixed in the lab combined policy.
Those who didn't had to deal with disappointment. Some students weren't as smart as others, so they failed a grade and were held back to repeat the same grade. Tests were not adjusted for any reason. Our actions were our own. Consequences were expected. The idea of parents bailing us out if we got in trouble in school or broke a law was unheard of. They actually sided with the school or the law. Imagine that. Now, this generation has produced some of the best risk takers, problem solvers, and inventors ever. We had freedom. Failure, success,
so
and responsibility.
Is, Don Lemon, who's a big show from one of these big media organizations, and here
really
he talks about conspiracy type shit for the missing plane.
Black holes and
it's
on
okay,
and on
they're kind of on board for it.
Theories. Let's look at this.
But when it's a
Noah
conspiracy
says,
for something more important,
black hole, Bermuda Triangle, and then
the missing plane could have went in the Bermuda
Triangle, just like the movie Lost.
A black hole.
It's also they're also referencing the Twilight Zone, which is a very similar plot.
Back up.
That's what people are saying. I know it's preposterous, but is it preposterous, you think, Mary?
Well, it is. A black hole is about, you know, a small black hole would suck in our entire universe, so we know it's not that. Bermuda Triangle is often weather, and Lost is a TV show. So I think I always like things for which there's data, history, crunch the numbers. So for me, those aren't there, but I think it's wonderful that the whole world is trying to help with their theories, and I absolutely love the theories.
Absolutely, because people are trying to find answers to something that's unexplained right now. But the big question, and I think, Jeff Beatty, you said this, or it may have been Arthur, a reward would be pennies on the dollar. What did you say?
Exactly. A reward. I'm getting asked by people, why isn't there a reward posted? A reward would be pennies on the dollar or
don't
what this service costs.
That's the last comment in the show. Thank you guys so much for joining us.
You're not taking sanctions.
So
against
to catch
I think I said that already. I'm not putting on or off any individual. You can see the scope provided by the executive orders that have been signed, and how individuals can fall into the categories outlined in those executive orders. But beyond saying that we are assessing regularly additional steps we could take and sanctions we could impose, I'm not going
I'm
to
all in. Those whoop elements mixed in the lab combined policy.
Who might be next if anyone is.
And by taking these actions and saying that they are targeted at those responsible for what's Russia's activity in Crimea, the White House is not suggesting that Vladimir Putin is not responsible for what Russia's done there.
Well, certainly we're not. The authorities are...
So why not sanction him? I'm just...
John, I feel like this is Groundhog Day from a briefing I had last week.
Well, now
the fact is
today, and mm-hmm. Putin's not on the list, so I'm asking why.
I would suggest that we have identified individuals today. We have the authorities to... more broadly identify individuals and entities in the future, and we will do that as necessary if the costs to Russia need to be increased because of Russian actions. What I won't do is speculate about who might be on a list of individuals who are sanctioned in the future. I can point you to the list of individuals who have been identified today, and they include obviously advisors to President Putin as well as senior figures in the
Duma.
Afterwards, membership in NATO.
I'll put in a penny if y'all stick in 99 cents for a like. Come and share it out,
and it'll be very interesting to see to what degree our European friends will join us, who are dependent on Russian energy
supply. That's the fuck the EU part. So it truly is. And if I can kind of help with the neocon agenda, and I think McCain's agenda, you're right. You know, he sees that with military-industrial complex, we're pulling out of kind of Iraq and Afghanistan, although we have a huge presence there and diplomatic and the biggest embassy in the universe. But we're pulling out.
Don't
we need to be going somewhere else.
Nothing
and we need
to
basically be mean to everybody and take
Bullshit.
Everybody's crap, all of your resources. They all belong to us. And I would agree that Russia is not the strongest it's been. And they're taking advantage of the situation. They're going, okay, we're going to go and get you, and we're going to just go, we're going to come in and take your lunch money.
Fact.
That's essentially what it is, and that's what these people do. And it
yes,
is
McCain
this,
particularly.
Yes, and everyone's getting in on it. So you have Noodleman, also known as Victoria Newman, but
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab, combined powerfully.
One half of the PNAC brothership, which is. What's the douche knuckle's name again?
I got it.
It's very important for my story. Hold on. Kagan. She's Kagan. Married to Robert Kagan, and his brother is Frederick Kagan, literally the guy who wrote the project for a New American Century, the neocons, who said, hey, we should have a Pearl Harbor, and then we should go into Iraq. Okay, so those guys. So, of course, you know, Noodleman is out of the State Department. Who's left? Jen Psaki. And she wants to jump in on everything because everyone's having a good time. Everyone's having fun, kicking the Russians in the face. And so she tweets out something. We had this, I guess one or two soldiers were killed, most likely by snipers, which would not necessarily be Russian. And she tweets out something to the effect of, oh, well, you know, Russians killing people. But she got called on it in her little briefing, and it resulted finally in a shut up slave moment. It was very embarrassing for her as she overstepped her boundary trying to get in on the action because it's so fun over there at the Skull and Bone State.
Sir, go ahead in the back.
You tweeted several hours ago, stop the shooting in Simferopol, clear that Russia shot first. And I'm just curious, what is this clarity based on? What are the facts behind this statement?
Well, Russia entered a Ukrainian base, and that's clearly an act that we have concerns about and shows their level of aggression in this case. So I think events on the ground seem pretty clear. In our view, I was just expressing a concern about
look
the reports
that.
We're hearing on the ground.
But now you said, you talked about entering a base, but in the tweet you were saying that it's clear that it actually fired a shot first. And that's a pretty...
And remember, she is the spokeshole for the State Department. So for her to say, well, Russians shot first, they shot first, bad guys shot first, is a big deal.
A serious allegation, so what is this information? Where is it coming from? Because there's been plenty of conflicting reports on what actually has been happening in Simferopol. So we're just...
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab, combined possibly.
True that the Russian claim that they were not that someone else was the aggressor, that the Ukrainians were the aggressor, can possibly be true, given they entered the Ukrainian base.
They're not saying that. They're saying it's a provocation, whereas
what?
You're
shut
saying that it's
one,
very
two,
clear.
Three.
Shut
and
up, I've said that a little bit. I think we're ready to move on.
We're ready to move on. Shut up.
What have Herbert Hoover, Art Linkletter, Jack London, Sarah, and Richard
about
Nixon,
Bohemian,
all
Bohemian Grove, which I could look up on your own, which is a fascinating place where some of the rulers of the world visit every year,
where every year at this
along
time
with
the elite from around the country get together for 2.5 weeks of fun and games. Steve Shepard has this special assignment report.
More than 2,000 members of San Francisco's
exclusive
and all-male Bohemian
play,
Club.
All male.
Have once again
doing
descended on Northern California.
Witcher movement.
These men
dead.
Will spend most of the month of July encamped on some 2,700 acres of pristine and privately owned redwood forest. Forest very much like this. The place is called Bohemian Grove, and it's located just 80 miles north of San Francisco. The Grove is the Bohemian Club's summer retreat, and its facilities are hidden beneath lush forest canopy extending south from the banks of Sonoma County's Russian River. For more than a century, the camp has been a place where club members and guests from all across America gather to relax. The retreat is divided into dozens of small camps, the most prominent of which is called Mandalay. Among its members are businessmen like Leonard Firestone and Edgar Kaiser, and political figures like Gerald Ford, Henry Kissinger, William French Smith, and George Shultz. President Reagan, Vice President Bush, and Defense Secretary Weinberger are members of other camps. Richard Nixon is a Bohemian, and so are high-ranking executives of such companies as Eastern Airlines, Standard Oil of Indiana, and Bank of America. For the most part, the men of Bohemian Grove are over 50, highly successful, and, according to many employees, politically conservative.
Well, each year, many of them seem to have a stunt or try to come up with a stunt. Last year, in 1980, the popular button was Free the Fortune 500.
Membership in the Grove is by invitation only and is determined by such factors as social standing, occupation, and personal connections. Privacy is one of the Grove's...
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab combined powerfully.
...record, speak, or write about activities at the retreat. While many public officials are Grove members, the press is a distinctly unwelcome guest.
We're from ABC News.
Well, get back there. Get back there.
Can we talk to somebody in
there? Get back there.
Anyone willing to navigate a boat up the Russian River can get a glimpse of the northern edge of the compound, but that's about all. Still, there are outsiders who have researched the Grove. Sociology professor William Dumhoff found out enough to write a book on the place.
Well, I think it's a playground for the powerful. It's a place where wealthy men from all over the United States gather for 2 weeks to relive summer camp with this ceremony called the Cremation of Care that begins the two-week encampment where the body of dull care, symbolizing woes and concerns, is burned on an altar in front of a big owl statue. When that ceremony ends, they all start to cheer and yell and hand each other a beer.
Other regular activities include the production of two plays, one of which involves major sets, orchestral music, and extravagant costumes. The other play appears to be just a bit on the lighter side, at least judging from these old photos. Members also spend time swimming, hiking, relaxing in the sun, and doing a bit of drinking from the Grove's own...
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab combined powerfully.
Number 25. And other people that weren't so nice people, but the quotes are actually pretty
keep saying it, and eventually they will believe it.
Golden Show, Golden Hate Show, where the MoneyMob.com.
Number 24. Death is the solution to all problems. No man, no problem. Joseph Stalin. Number 23. You cannot run faster than a bullet. Idi Amin. Number 22. There is no state with a democracy except Libya on the whole planet. Muammar Gaddafi. Number 21.
Bullshit.
Politics is when you say you are going to do one thing while intending to do another. Then you do neither what you said nor what you intended. Saddam Hussein. Number 20. Politics is war without bloodshed, while war is politics with bloodshed. Mao Zedong. Number 19. We love death. The U.S. loves life. That is the difference between us two. Osama bin Laden. Number 18. The only white man you can trust.
I'm all in. Those
warp
elements mixed in the lab combined powerfully.
Number 17. Ideas are more powerful than guns. We would not let our enemies have guns. Why should we let them have ideas? Joseph Stalin. Number 16. I will leap into my grave laughing because the feeling that I have 5 million human beings on my conscience is for me a source of extraordinary satisfaction. Adolf Eichmann.
In fact, even the environment,
a category
has a
for environment. Oh,
never
gosh.
Gets above, say, 1 or at most 2% of total news coverage. But it's not just the amount of media coverage.
Come on,
it's
man,
also
Eric,
the fact
talk about
there's
Justin
been a
Bieber
very active
Kardashian.
Disinformation campaign. That's been going on for many years. It's very well documented. That was primarily, certainly originally, and still to this day, driven by fossil fuel company interests, who are the world's most profitable companies. I mean, they're very happy, thank you very much, with the status quo. Okay?
And so what are they saying in this disinformation campaign?
Well, historically, this has been the key strategy all along. In fact, it's a strategy that was lifted explicitly, directly out of the tobacco wars, which is make people think that the science is still unsettled. And if my perception is that the experts are still arguing over whether the problem exists, as a layperson, my tendency is to say, well, you know, I'll let them figure it out, and you know, I'll take this as much more seriously once they've reached their conclusion. Okay, so that has been the primary message. That has been the primary strategy of that disinformation campaign, is to get people to believe that the experts do not agree.
There's something else that has come through, and I saw it, we all saw it, I think, throughout the campaign last year, the argument that we can't do anything about climate change.
Don't look over here!
Nothing to see!
Look at that! We're about to get out there! Bullshit!
Enormous amount of money being blown up,
operating on the coal.
Break this down. Break this down a little bit.
And then what's the cure?
How much money? Where's it going?
Well, look, there's a $3 trillion 2011 budget proposal. It'll probably go a little higher than the analysts do, but, you know, let's round it up. $3 trillion. $1 trillion
you are in it to win
that is being proposed for the next year. And of that, that includes...
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab combined powerfully.
$17 billion at this point. That'll also rise, as it always does. There's a proposal for $158 billion. They call it...
They call your taxes contingency fund, y'all. So they can eat more lobster and shrimp.
Then you got $40 billion in black box intelligence funding that doesn't get written in the budget, but really
what is that?
They never tell us how much they spend on the CIA and the NSA and the DIA and all these different intelligence activities, which are all war-related. But a couple of years ago, there was a error in testimony in the Congress that leaked that the black budget on intelligence was $37 billion. But I suspect that it's probably closer to $50 or $60 billion, because if you think about it, the CIA is basically running the Predator operation in Pakistan, and that's got to be hugely expensive. So, you know, I suspect that the intelligence budget is probably much more than $40 billion I gave it. Then you got another almost $100 billion in non-Department of Defense military spending, and that includes things like the military portion of NASA, military spending by the State Department. Remember, they hire all those military contractors to guard their embassy operation in Iraq and their embassy operation in Afghanistan and so on. It's pretty huge. Then you've got the Homeland Security budget that is largely military, and then the VA, $123 billion in veterans benefits for the damaged goods from all our wars. And finally, there's $400 billion in interest on the debt to pay for our prior wars, and that's just the interest. So that all
don't look over here.
$1.6 trillion, and sort of like, how does that compare to the recent health care bill? Like, what's the...
Oh, the recent health care bill was $1 trillion for 10 years, over 10 years. But we're talking about $1.6 trillion in 1 year.
$1.6 trillion. So we could have, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Next time you hear that the government needs to cut funds for providing medical care to the children of laid-off workers, or that supplemental unemployment...
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab combined powerfully.
Sort of like the Matrix, everybody. So I'm plugged. Golden Debate Show, GoldenShow.com. Let's get in with some music, my man. Big Mike, check. Golden Debate Show. Yeah.
Team liking. Looping on the floor plan. Let me enlighten. Briefing to this war plan. Bitch, we on a war path. Bitch, you want more math. And for that will, firebomb everything. I evolved to a king. I put that on anything. Anything, anything. Motherfucking anything. I don't give a fuck about you or your many men. Get brushed off like the dust on my Timberland. Rock the Famas. I call that French toast. And y'all niggas cinnamon. Sweet all day. I heard what they say. More money, more problems. But we over here just early morning mobbing. Trying to see green like a motherfucking goblin. Burning on the trees like a dragon in a garden. Bruce Lee flow. So lethal. Giant on the track, FIFO, Crippy and Cap, my people, please step back, I'm spitting C4, kaboom, I just came in the room with a handful of blunts and a pocket full of shrooms, about to take a trip to the motherfucking moon, if you ain't walk a mile in my kicks, don't assume that you know me, damn Mike, lighten up, nah, fuck that shit, kid, lighten up.
CT! We on fire!
Yeah.
CT!
Yeah, the I got that kryptonite, bring them hurry up to the Golden Show,
supernova shine, bring them saw the light. A monster, turn them, call the light. Just some more blowers as we getting right. I got that kryptonite, bring them raw the light. Supernova shine, bring them saw the light. I'm all stars, turn them, call the light. Just some more blowers as we getting right.
Mike gone, I got crazy flow. Real shit like a psycho. Freddie and Michael, burn it down like dro. Steal the crown, let's roll. Hey yo, the meds work for slow. Crash it, jacket, better latch it, breathing in the flow. Lips on the L, I can tell she's a hoe on the flow. Here we go, hit the flow, we double M and like and grow. If
you don't know, no, don't act new and just go. Most don't listen, so star like a zodiac, the whole show.
I'm all in, those warp elements mixed in the lab, combined powerfully.
You're hating cause you haven't reached your best, you got nothing in your chest. Such a lame, what a shame, fuck the whole game. Still make the Hall of Fame and just dig at her fucking frame. All star dad ahead of the game, big bat, don't fall in the trap. Make MCs look like it's fucking Iraq. Digging in the sand, time slipping. Hence you better listen, transmission gone. Better get that money up, yo, word is gone.
I got that kryptonite, bring them balls of light. Supernova shine, bring them stars of light. I'm on star, turn them balls of light. Just some more flowers, that's best for getting right. I got that kryptonite, bring them balls of light. Supernova shine, bring them stars of light. I'm on star, turn them balls of light. Just some more flowers, that's best for getting right.
Back at it, make a mathematic, puffing on that greenery, looking like a celery.
So let's get it in with a little go, Agenda News Network. New sanctions on Russia, what's the end game? The executive director of the Ron Paul Institute for Peace and Prosperity, Daniel McAdams, was interviewed on RT yesterday about the new round of U.S. sanctions on Russia officials. EU agreed banking union yesterday, global bail-ins cometh. Iraqi reporter killed by President Guard officials. Rhapsody and Napster leave Echo Nest following Spotify's takeover. Echo Nest must have developed cooties after Spotify bought it just days after Redo said it would stop using the song recommendation provider to avoid sharing data with a rival. Rhapsody has announced that it's ramping down its own Echo Nest deal. British architects who called the boycott of Israeli counterparts. South Africa, TB is the number one killer. North Korea fires 30 rockets into the sea amidst USS Korea drills. Not everything is sunny in the 100-acre woods. New study of collapse of genetic diversity and the risk of GMOs. But as we keep talking about these GMOs, people want to keep eating them up, but of course they're going to start making other ecosystems and stuff collapse.
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab, combined powerfully.
Thursday, I reported that Alex Papa's a Daily Caller had one summer interview with Rand Paul before Rand spoke at Berkeley. The Papa's report on the interview and up, it seemed as though Rand is getting sick of being asked why he is not as principled as libertarian and non-interventionalist Ron Paul, his father. Peak Organic Brewing becomes first non-GMO project verified beer. Non-GMOproject.org. Peak Organic Brewing Company is the first brewer to make non-GMO project verified beer. Since day one, we've always held a simple belief, pure ingredients make delicious beer, said John Crudux, founder of Peak Organic Brew. We love tasty beer, so we decided to make it beer with no GMOs. U.S. moves to push global trade deal on green goods. The United States said Friday it was planning to begin negotiations with other leading trade countries for a deal to cut tariffs for green goods like solar panels. Obama hanging on to his BlackBerry for now. Yeah, sure. Intellectual property and entrepreneurship in March, the free market. The March issue of the free market is now online, and its main focus is on intellectual property. Bill Gates has spent $2.3 billion on Common Core, the new curriculum driven by law by Secretary of Education Ian Duncan. The Common Core standards is a product of massive spending and is an unprecedented...
...the obvious threat to untold numbers of citizens, and because of the crisis which is even now developing, this radio station will remain on the air day and night. This station and hundreds of other radio and TV stations throughout this part of the country are pooling their resources through an emergency network hookup to keep you informed of all developments.
The ghost and the darkness have come.
Shalom.
On
the
flippity flips, ghosted.
See you on the next one, and like, comment, share as much as you possibly can to get the word out of this show. I'm trying to fight the big media and these vampires for the truth. Open minds out, everyone's golden.
I'm all in. Those warp elements mixed in the lab, combined powerfully.
Talking like that, we're talking.
bitch. Come bitch, see I'm a good flip. Long on line, anything better, fuck with me, chat. You know I'm coming after that. Go be so, go be bros, go be boss, go be